So good morning, everyone. Thank you for waking up. I feel I'm still dreaming. So many important people, but really, guys, I appreciate that you came. And today I want to present a brief overview of Open Source Design Collective. What goals does it have and what it has done so far? I hope it can be helpful for designers looking to be a part of open source movement and for developers that that need design help for their projects. So let me introduce myself, although we met already, but this is me. And I guess you can, you know, where am I? Any ideas? This is FOSS Asia 4 years ago. And this was very first open source conference for me, and was very interesting to come here as a UX researcher from a huge Korean company developing software for Android phones. And before that, I heard open source only in a sentence together with Android, and I didn't know what that means. So I didn't know anything about freedom and possibilities open source can provide until my first FOSS Asia. And I learned a lot, but I came home back puzzled and wondering, is there a designer, are there designers in open source? And I started to study open source movement, and I knew that open source can look like this, but on the other hand, it can look like this, and even like this. And I was like, okay, we have buttons, so maybe there are designers that can design it. So I set up on my journey to find out how a designer can contribute to open source. And I assumed that I wasn't probably the first one to do that. And first I searched academia papers on this topic. So I collected more than 40 papers on usability in open source. You can find them on this repository, GitHub. If you are into papers, I highly recommend to you to read one or two. It starts with a very famous white paper by Eric Steven Raymond. Probably you heard of the father of open source. And continues with the modern research on usability and methods in open source. So what I learned from those papers, that designers not contributing to open projects due to the lack of understanding how and what to contribute. And the feeling that non-code contribution values less than code contribution in the community. Design activities beyond of making things pretty are not understood by software, on the other hand, developers. And FOSS culture and values aren't necessarily understood by designers. So this makes it very difficult for designers to overcome and start contributing to open source over one night. And in order to come to common ground with designers and developers, we need to learn from each other how to share common language and common values. And then I stumble upon a place that tries to bridge the gap between developers and designers in open source. It's called Open Source Design Collective. I hope you heard about it. I know that some of you did work with the people from this collective, and this is amazing. And I want to tell you what we do and what are our goals. There are many goals that people in the community are trying to pursue, but I like to divide them in two different areas. First one is to create physical and digital space for designers to learn FOSS way of working and collaborate. And the second one, more practical, support a space for developers and designers to meet each other. And we have it in the form of job board, which I will explain later. So why we need a physical space? Why we need to get designers together? Like I said, designers, I still have a lot of things to learn, especially when it comes to free software values and culture. And even more when it comes to design principle and methodology, because for software it's very easy. It works in open source the best way, but design methodology doesn't necessarily can be applied to distributed way of work. So we need to learn how to use UX research and design in distributed environment. We also desperately need open source tools for designers. There are not so many out there. It's also a goal for us to welcome more non-code contributions and make open source more inclusive. So we do it for different resources, and one of them is our website, where we post everything related to events, news, projects, and design in open source. OpenSourceDesign.net, please check it out. There you can find articles, event announcements, and our job board and forum, links to the forum. We also, here's our Twitter, we have more than 2,000 followers, and there we try to reach a wider audience for the open source. Welcome to the most popular talk, as we decided today in the morning. So that's our way to reach the wider audience. Of course, we are on GitHub. We not only maintain our website here, but also teach designers about Git, versioning control, and so on. And I believe that one day there will be a versioning control system for design work. Also, there's another resource available. It's our Discourse forum for UX research and design-related topics. And as I said, we create not only digital spaces for designers to meet and talk about usability, but also we make sure that we meet several times a year to discuss our projects in person. And one of the biggest gathering for us is FOSDEM. If you haven't been, it's a free and open source software developers European meeting happening in Brussels every February. Here you can see topics we discussed this year. Everything from GitLab design system and why they need to build one to usability testing in open source. So we are growing. This is FOSDEM 2017. And this us this year. You can see me there in a blue t-shirt, tired but happy. So please follow up FOSDEM talks to learn more. And also we encourage our members to run meetups in their cities, and you can see that we have meetups, the biggest one in New York, in Boston, in Germany, Berlin, Tirana in Albania, Madrid, where I'm from. And if you want to run one in Singapore, please be our volunteer, and we can give you all support you need for that. And also this year we tried something new. We run a separate dedicated event called Open Source Design Summit, where we discuss the future of the collective. This time it was in Berlin, but we want to reach out to other areas as well, and maybe this year it will be in Albania. Hopefully one year we'll come to Singapore. This is us, some of the people. And also we think it's very important to widen our audience, so we try to affiliate with the communities in open source. So we are affiliated with the Free Software Foundation Europe in the process of affiliation with the EFF and Open Source Initiative. Also our group is fully supported by volunteers, and we donate money to print stickers if you want one, very pretty stickers on the first table, please pick one, and some technical needs. However, this year, first time we received our first donation from Discourse, and we're very happy to get recognition in the community. So we print more stickers for you guys. And as I said, the second goal is more practical, to support digital spaces where developers and designers can find each other. And we think the best way to do that during our first steps is to maintain a job board. So job board, you can, let me share a real website. So this is how it looks like, it's coming. You can see that this is all postings. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Postings from requests from developers, and they can be very different. It can be logo, or it can be redesign the whole website. It can be research user research request. It can be voluntary job, and also some developers even ready to pay. Some projects have budgets for that can be sponsored by some funds. So if you're a beginner designer, it's a great way for you to pick up a small task and start contributing to open source and build your portfolio. And if you have a project which you and you need a design help, then you can post it here and find someone to work with together. Posting here is very easy. You can just click post a job and go to a forum, explain what you're looking for, and hopefully someone will pick it up. We have very interesting requests, for example, redesign Apache Maven website, and you can see the discussion is very active. People are suggesting ideas, how it should look like, and also we have different types of discussion. Also, one of Apache projects requested a new logo, and it was a very huge, long discussion with people contributing different ideas to Camel project. So it's a lot of fun. And also, what I want to say that open source design community is self-organized and a little bit chaotic group. So you just, if you want to join, just pop up there, become a member, talk what you do at your daily job, organize a meetup in your city. And like one member of our community answered on a question, why are we doing that? She said, just not to feel lonely in open source. So don't be lonely, join us. And if you are a student, I know a student or a young designer, there is a very interesting program that I wanted to advertise. It's run by Outreach, a program by Software Freedom Conservancy. They provide paid remote internship for people that are traditionally underrepresented in tech. And what's interesting, you can find the internship there for user experience, graphic experience, documentation, web development, and even marketing. So please apply if you're interested. It's run twice a year. And I think for this batch, you still can apply. The deadline is today or something. So it's your chat. Thank you very much. I hope to see you at our community and other activities. And our next goal is actually to have a full dedicated design room at FOSS Asia. If you want to help us host one, let's do it together and let's discuss usability issue next year here in Singapore. Thank you. If you have any questions, all clear, good. I'm also a moderator of this track, so welcome to the open source, open design, imaging, hardware track. It's maybe the longest name. So our next, I will open our schedule. Our next, good morning. Our next talk will